it's on now.
I'm Caboose Mikey, and this is our new surprise module. Down here, not up here.
I know, but I'm looking at you.
Great. Would you please look at the module? This will be Caboose Junction. You'll notice the blue foam doesn't look very realistic. So, we have whipped up Sculpt the Mold. We, instead of the white-looking snow, which we don't want in case it cracks, which it will from the rough handling it will get going to conventions and shows, so we have added a little tint to this sloppy-looking stuff. And we're just going to slather it on so there's no blue foam left. When it dries up, it's water-based. Easy to handle, easy to color, easy to clean up. When it is finished, we will add some scenery on the top. It is extremely lightweight paper mache. You'll see that our new mystery module, the 216 Caboose Junction, joins right up to the Roseland trestle. And we're just trying to lay in this base. Okay, we'll be back. Got a lump here that I will just lay. And it's a simple matter to lay a little stuff on there. If we used the original Hydrocal plaster, the layer would have to be very thick to keep it from cracking, and it would weigh a ton. So we've got very lightweight Hydrocal. Sculpt a Mold. The concrete piers that hold up the trestle were cast out of Sculpt a Mold because it's extremely easy for me to work with. I made a master model out of hickory wood, made a rubber mold, and they are over here in, underneath this trestle, and then I cast them individually. The trestle itself is a micro-engineering trestle. In fact, there are 12 kits put together, and I built all the bents, cast the piers themselves, and master modeler Bob Arsenault helped me put the entire trestle together and in place.